Russian Ballet Icons Gala, held on Sunday, March 9th at the London Coliseum, brought some of the most talented dancers in the world under the spotlight for a triumphant celebration of Russian ballet. A tribute to the Russian legends of the past, from Maya Plisetskaya to Rudolf Nureyev, the event saw performances by Vadim Mundagirov and Sergei Polunin, Maria Alexandrova of the Bolshoi Ballet, and Alina Somova, prima ballerina at the Mariinsky Theatre. Russian ballet is what is described as the emotional sense of life, the emotional perception of music. Any movement or pa, however slight, is an emotional component. The performance is very much alive and direct, but at the same time harmonious, because ballet is in the blood of Russians, who have embodied it and made it their own. Musicality, lyricism, and harmony are inherently Russian characteristics.
I think here in England it's a little bit different repertoire. And I would say it's in a way you have to express yourself more here because of the repertoire. So in a way it's a different way of work. So I think especially for me who've been trained in Russia, it's great to take part of English technique, because it's good to have a bit of both.
It's like Russian audience have to see, and a lot of people, like, it's their life to see a ballet, you know, they talk about it, they live with that, and it's on a different level, I would say, than in England. In England it's like a theater, you know, like West End, or you just go and see it, but in Russia it's you know, the huge respect for ballet dancers.
I had visited London many times with the Mariinsky Theater. During my 10 years at the theater, I have been in London 3 times. London audiences are demanding, very demanding indeed. The public there is used to outstanding artists and grand troupes. They are not starved of top performance and demand the very highest level of execution.